Welcome back to Sports on Tap, part of the NEO Sports Insiders Network. I'm Rob Trump. We have Ed Dick, Sean Duffy, Josh Jeffy, and our next guest is coming off of a 3-0 win versus Menor here at the Barron Cup tournament in Brooklyn. Want to welcome in Chris Cogan, the head coach of the Rocky River Pirates, and also defenseman Matt Goepfert to come on to our show here today. Thanks for taking time, guys, to spend a little time with us and talk a little bit about the game tonight.
Absolutely. Thanks for having us, and thanks for being here.
Oh, no problem. First, Coach, let's talk a little bit about the game tonight. You're coming off a 3-0 victory versus Menor. You played them earlier in the season. How does this win match up? It's tough to beat a team three times, but you've done it now this year. How does it feel to get a big win here in the tournament?
Yeah, it's obviously a great start for us. I mean, at this point in the season, it's one or done. So, we jumped out to a quick lead there, and I think, offensively we had the right idea of what we were trying to accomplish. But after we scored that first one, I think we were kind of standing around doing a little bit of watching, too much watching. So not extremely happy with the rest of the game, although the victory is always good to have. So 3-0 for us, and, it was nice. And the guys, they finished the game, the way they had to. So nothing else broke down. But I think there's stuff that we can work on and get better.
Matt, your thoughts?
Yeah, we could have cleaned up in our defensive zone a lot better today. We look to get back at it on Saturday against the winner of this next game. It's always nice to have a shutout, too. Builds up some confidence for our goalie and also our defense, and then building up to our forwards.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's funny you talk about the things you guys need to clean up, and you guys didn't give up any points, any goals out there. Your defense seemed like, overall, from watching the game, you guys really did a nice job keeping the rebounds. A lot of times off of shots, they like to try to go down there and score a quick goal, but you guys cleared it a lot of times and did a really nice job there.
Yeah, early in the season, we were pretty weak at cleaning rebounds. So we picked that up throughout the season and took care of those second-chance opportunities, got them to the corner.
So you guys will take on the winner of Hudson and Solon. You guys are both very familiar. You guys are very familiar with both of those teams, and you guys have had some success against those teams this year. Is there a specific team that you would rather play, one or the other? And how would you go about approaching that game either way?
Yeah, no, we have definitely played those teams a couple times, and, they were actually close games. Our division this year in our league was very competitive. There was no room to take a night off or really a shift off. So, as far as who we'd like to play, any game in this tournament I think is going to be a tough one. So, like I said, the division was very tight, and they're all going to be good games.
And you actually – you played Hudson and Solon early on in the season. You beat Hudson 8-2 early on. Solon, you beat 5-4, and that was an overtime win early on. And then 9-4, you beat Solon, and a 4-2 win against Hudson. So some pretty close games, and then some games you jumped out early. And you guys have kind of been on a roll. I mean, a very impressive record, 21-9 overall. And 10-1 and 1 in the league. Talk about your success so far this year. I mean, what have you guys done consistently to keep your players grinding? I mean, you guys play a lot of games. I mean, that's, you have 30 to 31 games you guys are playing to keep a high school kid's focus for that long. Talk about what you do as a coach to really keep their focus for that long with the season.
I wish I had that answer for you. we're 3 months into this, and they do an excellent job of coming to the rink and being prepared and just wanting to play. It's like when they walk in the door, they leave everything else outside for that hour and a half we're there. But, some of those other games you were mentioning, the 9-4 games, those were like early in the year tournament games, so like not into league play. But, these guys, like, again, getting back to the team here, we rely a lot on our defense. They're seniors. They've been around. They've played in big games for us before. We play a pretty competitive schedule outside of our league as well. We get in teams or tournaments with the Great Lakes leagues, like Walsh, Holy Name, Sylvania Northview. So we're playing against good competition to get us prepared for this point in the season. And, that's part of our plan is, to throw these guys into games like that and get them ready. And, again, laying on these seniors defensively, they've been around. And they help kickstart our offense. So they've done an excellent job.
One question I have, Coach, is you mentioned that this part of the year it's one and done. How important is it really to keep that, pounding that into the players' mentality? I mean, like you said, tonight they got out to a really fast start, and then all of a sudden they started watching. How critical is the focus factor here? And you can even talk a little bit about it too, given this point in the season. As you mentioned, it's win or go home.
I mean,
you know?
That's just it. You know, nobody wants to lose now. So from here on out, you know, we consider this part two of the season. Mm-hmm. Our regular season's over. Now we're in Barron Cup. It's a short 3-game season, and these guys, you know, they want to continue the success that we've had. Back-to-back champions of the Barron Cup, and they want to keep the name going, so they're working hard.
Excellent.
Matt, you have any thoughts on that?
Yeah, it'd be awesome to get a three-peat here on the Barron Cup, and also
keeping your focus.
Right.
Good thing you didn't do that in the game, right?
You left it all out there.
He's still focused on the game. He's fine. He's fine.
He's going to check the fool here.
You know, we're a close group of guys in the locker room. We always stick around late after practice, hanging around, always laughing. But when we get on that ice, it's always serious, and we're always hard at work, and we listen to our coaches. Very respectful group of guys we got this year.
Go ahead, Ed.
Let's talk a little bit about the, you know, early in the season. You know, how have you guys really progressed from the beginning of the season all the way up to this point?
I thought we were a very selfish team, but throughout the season we've got to know each other. We've been playing with each other a lot now that we're passing the puck better, we're communicating better, and also just getting along in general, which is huge.
Well, Coach, we'll ask you one last question so you can go down and scout the two teams coming up. But, you know, looking ahead, what do you guys want to do to clean up to prepare for, you know, the team ahead? What do you guys want to – I mean, obviously you don't know who's going to win this game, but what would you like your team to do better, whether it's defense or offensively, for the upcoming game?
Like I said before, I think offensively we can do some better things when we have control in the zone. I think there was a lot of standing around and just not enough movement, and wasn't really producing anything. We had looks when we were standing, but they weren't clean looks. So want to get more guys involved offensively, and even, you know, the defensemen, because there's a lot of time that D's wide open and we're not giving them the puck. So that's pretty much.
How many goals do you have this year, Matt?
Eight.
As a defenseman.
There we go. That's pretty good.
I mean, defensemen usually aren't going to score a lot, but if you score at all, that's pretty big.
And it's really good that you really don't know, because that means it's not important. Stats
there
are important.
It is. Exactly.
Wins
right.
Are.
Always bringing
it like
on the stat sheet all year.
As long as you have more goals defense instead of goals scored, life's good.
Plus or minus. But, hey, thank you guys for coming on and talking to us a little bit. And hopefully we'll talk to you guys again sometime. And we appreciate coming on Sports on Tap.
Thanks a lot. Good luck.
Thanks, guys.
All right, that's head coach of the Rocky River Pirates, Chris Cogan. I want to thank him for joining us, and also defenseman Matt Goepfert for coming on our show. They're coming off a 3-0 win over Menor. They face the winner of Solon and Hudson coming up from the 45th Barron Cup here in Brooklyn, Ohio. All coming up, we're Sports on Tap.